Welcome back to our course on Project 2013. In the previous section, we started our project for building a house. We just put one task in, prepare site, and I talked a little bit about duration, start date, etc. But before we go on to put the rest of the main tasks into this project, I need to look at a couple of very important things that you're always going to need to consider when you're using Microsoft Project. And the first of these is project information. On the Project tab in the Properties group, there is a button, Project Information. Click on that and it brings up a dialog, the Project Information dialog. Now, right at the top, we have a project start date. And as you saw in the previous section, by default, and we'll come back to that in a moment, our tasks are being scheduled to start on the project start date. Now, effectively, because I decided that I want to set this project a little bit in the past, that I need to change the start date. And you can always change the start date by going into Project Information and setting the start date here. Now, it might well be that you rarely want to set a start date in the past because hopefully you're planning your projects for some time in the future. But whether it's the past or the future, it's absolutely fundamentally important that you set the start date correctly. So let's click on the drop down here, use the date picker, and we're going to set the start date to March 4th, which is where I scheduled that first task to begin. So click on that and my start date is now changed. So if we were building a house and we had a start date of March 4th, the chances are that our objective would be to finish building the house as soon as possible. And one of the things that we would be using Microsoft Project for would be to help us to schedule the work on building the house, which would enable us to finish as quickly as possible, get the house on the market, sell it, get the money for it. However, that's not the only sort of project scheduling requirement. And if you just go down a couple of controls to there, you find one that says schedule from project start date. You'll use this a lot. You're saying start on March the 4th, do the scheduling from the start date and get it finished as quickly as possible. But there is another option, and if you click on this one, the other option is project finish date. And there are some projects where your objective is not to start now and finish as soon as possible, but to start as late as possible with the objective of finishing on or by a particular date. So for example, supposing that you were planning a wedding, or supposing that at work you were planning a big event, maybe a company meeting, maybe an announcement to the press, your objective would be to finish by a certain date, not to start on a certain date. And in that case, the point I made about making absolutely sure that your start date is right would become equally important for your finish date. And that is, you'd have a finish date and you'd know, I must be finished by that date. And rather than saying, as with the start date scheduling, that I want to finish as soon as possible, you may say, here's my end date, but I want to start as late as possible. So I don't want to start getting ready for this event now if I don't need to. Tell me how late I can leave my preparations. Now, they're the two fundamental ways of working with Microsoft Project. Most of the time on this course, we're going to be using scheduling from the project start date. But note that scheduling to a project end date is equally valid. If I chose project finish date, watch what happens. I now enter the finish date, not the start date, and project will tell me when I need to start. As it is, with my project start date of March the 4th, project tells me that currently my project will finish on March 15th. Of course, it will finish then because at the moment all I'm doing is preparing the site, which is 10 days' work. Now let's look at a couple of the other fields on this project information dialog. First of all, the current date is in the top right. You can actually set that to a different date if you need to enter information as though it were entered on a different date. And closely associated with that, we have the status date below that, which we're going to look at later when we look at progress tracking on a project. A project will have a calendar and by default it uses what's called the standard calendar. You can have a number of calendars associated with a project. For example, some of the people working on it may have their own working hours and may have their own calendars, and some of the resources you use may also have their own calendars as well. We'll look at calendars later on in the course. Below that we have the project's priority, and this is used when different projects might be competing for the resources that are available, and a project's priority will determine what priority it gets in claiming and using those resources. At the bottom of the dialog we have access to help, and we also have access to project statistics that we'll look at a little bit later on in the course as well. You can also define custom fields for a project in Project 2013. We're not going to be using custom fields on this course. So that's the basic project information. I've changed the start date to March 4th, so click on OK to save that. So having updated the project information, we can now turn our attention back to entering the rest of those tasks for this project. We're going to do that in the next section, so please join me for that.
Hi everyone, Simon here from Simon Says It. Thanks for watching this video. If this is your first time here, I'd love for you to subscribe. Every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, new videos are uploaded to the Simon Says It channel here on YouTube. Just click on the subscribe button right over there. If you're interested in taking your Microsoft Project 2013 training to the next level, you can get 19 hours of Project 2013 training offered by Simon Says It. Just check out the About section below this video with more details. We'll see you next week with additional videos.